What's up, everybody?
Wojciech Lepczyński here. Today I show you how to automatically delete files from S3 after 30, 90 and 365 days automatically. I show you how to use lifecycle rule. Think of it as a vacuum cleaner that clean up your S3 and remove all files. On a simple server, you can set a script in CRON that automatically delete old files, for example logs, after a specific time. But not everybody knows that you can use something like that in S3. What is more important, you can delete files only from one specific folder in S3. How to do that? I show you in this video. But first, quick intro. Welcome again! First, log into your AWS account as user with permission to S3 or as admin. Then you can do everything. Go to S3. Choose your bucket. As you see, I have three folders in my bucket. I want to delete files from this folder after 30 days, from this folder after 90 days, and from this folder after 365 days. But other files and folders I won't keep. Before we go to management, I copy name of this folder. Now go to management. Now you can click create lifecycle rule. Add some name. For example, delete files older than 30 days. In this place, you add name of your folder and backslash. Remember, on the end must be backslash. Whoa, there is more options, but more about this later. Now, straight to the point. In lifecycle rule action, choose expire current version of object. And set 30 days. If you want to delete files older than 30 days. Remember, you must be very careful when you delete something. Now just click create rule. And that's all. Now I copy name next folder. And I create next rule. From this folder I want to delete files after 90 days. I add name folder and of course backslash. Also I choose expire current version of object. But now I set 90 days. Create rule. And the last. I copy name of this folder. I want to delete files after 365 days. But I choose the wrong folder name and AWS warning me that I already have a rule set for this folder. Let's go back and copy right name of folder. Again add name, delete files after 365 days, add name of your folder and backslash. And choose expired current version of object. Now set 365 days. Because I want delete files older than 365 days. As you see, I have three lifecycle rules. First rule, delete files older than 30 days from one folder. Second rule, delete files older than 90 days. And the last rule, delete files older than 365 days. Now, I will tell you about other possibilities. If you change this, you can delete all files in this bucket, not only in one folder. Remember, you must be very careful when you delete something. Of course, you don't need always delete files. You can, for example, move files to other storage classes. If you check this, you move current version of object between storage classes. As you see, there is many storage classes. I choose one zone AI. I want to move object to this class after 30 days. And of course I can set next transition, for example to glacier. And move object to glacier after 90 days. I move object to one zone AI after 30 days, and after 90 days I move this object again to Glacier. When I say current version, I mean the newest version, because if you turn on versioning, you can have multiple version of object. And I can also move this old version to one of these storage classes. And the last two options. Permanently delete non-current version object is easy to understand, but delete expired object, delete markers or incomplete multipart upload is not so obvious. So, let me explain. If you initiate a multipart upload but never finish it, the in-progress upload occupies some storage spaces and will incur storage charges. However, these uploads are not available when you list the contents of a bucket and when you delete a versioned object, a delete markers is created. If all previous version of this object subsequently expire, delete markers is left. These markers don't incur storage charges. You don't have to pay for this. However, removing unneeded delete markers can improve the performance of S3 list operation. Oh, of course, check my blog on lepczynski.it. You will find there a lot of tutorials that will show you how to use the AWS cloud and take you step by step to the next level. Thanks for watching.